American LCS. We're jumping right into it. Our first game of the day, Team Solo Mid versus XDG Gaming. There were people who thought TSM might be an easy target when Bjergsen was out, but they had a perfect super week going 4-0 and an overall 5-1 with Reginald in the mid lane.
Yeah, those people were definitely a little bit wrong there. The trick now is to see if Bjergsen can transition back as easily as when Reginald filled in. I mean, Bjergsen's been traveling. He's been out of the gaming house for 3 weeks. He hasn't been practicing with the team, which I think is the most important part. So we're going to have to see if that takes its toll on the team overall.
And while TSM still holds first place and is the team to beat, XDG has been stuck in last for a few weeks now.
Yeah, they've shown new life with their last player rotation and the addition of Sheep. They had last week off as well, which gave the team more time to play together and hopefully can build the team up some chemistry. They have 8 games left, and everyone becomes really important as teams look forward towards the summer promotion tournament.
And while XDG is struggling to find its footing, they face TSM, a team that has been nothing but consistent.
XDG, like, sometimes they play really well. We're hoping we can get them on the downswing.
TSM's a really tough team to face because of how solid all their players are. They play a really strong standard game where they just pick really strong picks and just capitalize on lead.
For us, as long as we're even or ahead early game, we tend to win.
In my opinion, they have the new term of most potential. It's gonna be up to the solo laners to carry again, just like before. It's eventually going to get to a level where everyone can carry, and that's where they're going to have to get out.
Everybody's going to have to get on the carry level.
Oh, yeah.
See if they can make it. Dyrus said he can have a big impact in these games, but we'll have to see if he can really do it. He's been kind of maining the meta champions
back as well. It's not completely on Dyrus to make it in big.
That's true.
Wild Turtle stepped up a whole bunch in the off time, but it really is TSM, everyone getting better this year.
We'll have to see. The KDAs are quite high for the team. As we check out the starting lineups on the blue side, it is Team Solo Mid. Dyrus in the top lane, Odwin in the jungle, Bjergsen in mid, Wild Turtle at AD carry, and Xspecial just pondering on support.
Yeah, and on the red side, of course, it is XDG. Benny in the top lane, Smithy in the jungle, Mancloud in mid, Zuna on AD carry, and Sheep on support.
We'll see if Dyrus can get himself into a good carry position for this one. Zuna saying, feel my hands, they're quite cold, trying to get into this one. Mancloud offers the hand warm, and it looks like the synergy of the team has been complete. We've seen Zuna getting the dance back in a little bit.
Yeah,
XDG's finding
he breaks out the dance when
ways.
They win, which unfortunately for them this year hasn't been as much.
That's true.
So as long as the dance is ready to go, if they're able to win this game, this would be a huge upset, by the way, if TSM was able to knock out XDG. Number 8 versus number 1 in the standings.
Yeah. XDG would definitely get the momentum they need to continue carrying on wins that need to get them up in the brackets here. Team Solo Mid is sitting at 17-3 now in the spring split. Looking for that 25-3 possible in the end that Cloud9 had last year. See ban percentages underneath the champions here as we get into picks and bans.
Very important thing to note is we are on the 4.3 patch, which is one patch back from what players are playing on live right now. So the Kassadin rework has not happened yet. It is a nerfed Kassadin that had stopped being banned a little bit in some games, but obviously in this one, it is feared. Ryze ban is, I think we're going to be seeing a lot more of that as well.
Ryze got his first ban after Nian played it. No big surprise there. It definitely caused a lot of havoc in that game.
He actually saw a lot of mid lane play over in the European LCS as well. So he's a double lane threat as far as where you're picking him, which just increases his value even more in the pick ban phase, which better explains the bans. Final for Jason.
Lulu. Yeah, during Super Week, Lulu, you don't say. She actually had a few support plays. Lemon Nation actually took that on support as teams were trying to just get her off the pick and ban phase. At least get them into a support position so she's not wreaking havoc in middle as she has been.
Yeah, it seems like we have a slightly different ban phase. Obviously, Ryze and Lulu have leaked into it. This last ban, I do wonder about the value of Kha'Zix for TSM in particular. Mm-hmm. Odwin hasn't been the most prolific Kha'Zix player. Actually hasn't played it at all this split. There's only been one Kha'Zix pick by TSM here, and that was from Bjergsen in the mid lane. Although, with the ultimate evolution that people have been talking about.
Yeah, that's true. We saw Skara play it. Skara went with that. He actually leveled up the ultimate first as well. Dyrus picking out Renekton. So he can be a lane bully. We'll have to see. Benny needs to play something that can get by in the early part of that lane. And that's kind of something I was hoping that XDG would have in their picks. Not something that would be safe in lane. Something that they could already take control of TSM.
Undefeated on Renekton is Dyrus.
Yeah.
Hasn't played it too much. Sometimes he gets banned against them, actually. So getting it through here is pretty valuable. XDG, you know, they're probably just going to be going with their standard stuff. I don't think with the 2 weeks off they would pick crazy types of compositions to come up with, but I do think they do need to make a bit of a mix-up. I'd like to see a Kha'Zix coming out from Xsmithie in the Jungle, because he knows Stealth Champions pretty well with all of his Evelynn experience, and Kha'Zix plays a little bit more like Eve now with the stealth changes than in the past.
Well, Xsmithie will be looking to blow some people up from the jungle. This is actually Sheep getting in on his first Thresh game. He's been Leona, Morgana, and Annie coming in. You can see the Thresh Warden statistics there. We'll see what Sheep can do on it. Definitely taking that away from Xspecial as well. Xspecial has 7 plays on Thresh already at 6-1.
Yeah. It was actually really strange in Super Week when XGG was playing with Sheep, because oftentimes they would ban Thresh on their own side.
Yeah.
Even though it was one of Sheep's most prolific champions in solo queue, I think it was just kind of the stage jitters they wanted to get out of him, knowing that Thresh is such a mechanically complex champion. Getting it through now, they hope he has his footing.
They actually go for the Eve themselves to be locked in for the odd one. We'll see what kind of sneaky play he can get around. And just one of the top two coming in for Wild Turtle is his Lucian. Both him and Sivir have 7 plays for Turtle.
Would Bjergsen pick Zed blind into what XGG is playing? He is probably the best Zed in North America, I'd have to say. He pulls out some wicked plays on him. Yeah, it's locked in. Good to see that Zed.
Definitely one of his go-tos when, like you said, picking it blind, he can keep it completely safe. Playing his shadow game might be, like you said, one of the best in North America, and we'll get to see that here. Quite excited about it as the last pick comes in from ManCloud. His champion pool grown quite a bit. He's at 11 unique champions. We'll see if he makes it 12 here. Orianna, Kha'Zix, and LeBlanc were played back in Super Week. Yeah. We'll see what he has here.
It's going to be tough for him to pull out something strong enough to face up against Bjergsen Zed. Gragas is something he's tried to default to 4 times this season, but he's actually winless with it. 0-4. And Gragas had a very, very tiny nerf as well, a couple patches back, taking 0.1 off his AP Shrub's ultimate. But okay, these teams in general, XGG actually has a fair amount of team fight potential, but they're going to need to work to get themselves out of the laning phase against a team as good as at laning as TSM, especially with the jungle Eve. The early game lane pressure is going to be huge coming out of TSM, and this is TSM going for that 20 to 30 minute win right off the bat.
And what's the objective now of Xsmithie then, if they're trying to get Eve a fast start? Do you look for Eve, or do you try to create pressure in other lanes to make Eve come to you?
You got to guess where Eve is most of the time.
You got to guess where.
It's one of the most difficult things to jungle against. Pro teams are generally pretty good at it, just knowing the general jungle rotations of players and then seeing the way people play in lanes to maybe know that a jungler's there. But aside from that, it's really difficult to jungle against an Eve, and Xsmithie has to guess.
We'll see if Xsmithie guesses correctly as the teams load onto the Rift. Let's check the voting at lolesports.com. It's 94% of you thinking that Team Solo Mid will take the win.
94%.
I think that ranks up there with one of the highest vote.
Yeah, one of the highest votes. There. TSM also had a 94% vote against Team Coast when they're upset a couple of weeks back. And there has been some off time. We had the off week for the IM World Championships in Katowice. Bjergsen just getting back to the team now. There will be that extra little bit of an adjustment period. But, I mean, if we're talking about adjustment periods, just look at XGG's roster. They've done role swaps. They've had a new support come in. They're still going to be just as up in the air as TSM.
Yeah, and TSM, their roster switch up pretty much didn't favor them, but it didn't hurt. It didn't really go either way.
What was it, 5-1?
5-1, the record altogether. Bjergsen's KDA right now is 6.56. And while Reginald was playing, he got a 6.13. So he provided for the team as Bjergsen would have. It was like nothing happened there. So
MVP of Super Week as well?
Yeah, MVP of Super Week. The communication with Team Solo Mid is kind of just on top all the time. And if for somebody to be changed out, puts them at regular. It's kind of crazy. It doesn't put them under at all.
Yeah, puts them as the best team in North America.
Yeah. So here we are loading onto the Rift. Everybody excited, ready to get into this game. We are 9 weeks in. 81 games so far in the spring split. Now TSM versus XDG is going to face off on the Rift.
Maybe some gimmickry coming out from XGG early on in the game.
I like that word.
This is still the 4.3 patch, so the trinkets will be able to be placed at 1 minute 30 seconds. I expect we'll see a lot more of this type of invading once the 4.4 patch hits, but not today. Xspecial, trying to charge up his stun, but if he's standing in that spot, he would be able to see XGG coming around. It's actually a pretty smart brush to stand in against a Thresh, he won't get blindsided by a hook over the wall. He'll see them and be able to run away.
Yep, slowly playing it safe. Everybody else has kind of spread themselves out across the map, so they know what's going on, and they're going to keep it safe, as we say. Hard hats on here for XTG. Team Solo Mid's just going to wait it out. See what Wild Turtle can do with that Lucian in the early game. He loves to apply early pressure. Special will get in there. Always trying to figure out how he can get the double stun in. You won't see him really use it until he can get both people locked up, majority of the time.
Yeah, very brutal bottom lane, Wild Turtle and X-Special. X-Special, just a note. We mentioned it in the preview show a few days back, but he leads all NALCS players, and actually LCS players, in kills, KDA, goal per minute,
yep.
Pretty much every relevant stat, aside from kills per game, which Bjergsen has. Because he was out for his 6 games.
Yep.
Bjergsen's actually still second place in kills in the LCS, despite missing basically 3 weeks worth of games.
The team just keeps it going. We were just talking about X-Special. He's done that all on only 3 champions so far. Somehow he's able to find Annie, Thresh, or Leona so far in 9 weeks of the LCS. Now Annie in this game. We'll see how the bottom lane fares for TSM against XDG's Caitlyn and Thresh. Xmithie picking up the blue. Looks like he won't get too much help. We've kind of put a focus on that level 2 in the bottom lane, and you won't see the junglers getting too much help lately.
Yeah, I do think it's really interesting how the jungle pulling has evolved in these pro games. Level 2 in lane has such a premium now that AD carries and supports aren't even helping the jungler because they're just trying to push the wave as quickly as possible. It makes it a little bit harder on junglers early on in the game, quite honestly.
Everybody's going to stay safe for the majority of the early game. Mirrored wards disappear on the bottom side of the map, so it does get a little scarier. But the buddy system will keep the AD carry support safe. We do see the hover from the Odd One towards the bottom side. He's going to go for golems. I don't know if he's going to get something too early. You can see Zuna getting aggression here from X-Special, and that passive shot is going to put more into Zuna. Doing a great job at making sure that Sheep really isn't too much of a threat.
Yeah, that's exactly what you want to do on Annie if your AD carry gets hooked early on in the game. Stun the other AD carry, and then just trade the damage, because Thresh in himself isn't going to be crushing Wild Turtle without that AD carry support. And here might come an E.
It could happen. We'll have to keep an eye on X-Special's Pyromaniac trying to charge that up and get the stun down. Level 3 for the Odd One. A red buff still ticking on him, but it looks like they're not going to pursue a gank. They do see Xmithie in the mid lane real quick. I believe Bjergsen might have gotten an eye on him there, but he's going to head down, and they might match up with Odd One.
Yeah, that's the best thing a enemy jungler can do against Eve is just see her in the jungle, because that lets every lane know. It's basically like having wards. Notice how there's actually no wards down for TSM, mostly, because warding the river or your conventional ward spots just doesn't work against Eve. It's very... changes the game, really.
Dyrus doing as a Renekton would, pushing up to the turret here. Benny's taking a few hits, but he's able to keep the CS within range. Dyrus is going to take an advantage there, and we'll see how big that gets in the next few minutes. Mid lane isn't going too bad either. Every lane actually going in favor of TSM. Like I said before, XDG really needs to get a good clip and a lead out of the lanes to do well.
Exactly. Like we said in the pregame, TSM is going to look to dominate these lanes. Mm. Even though Odd One hasn't been ganking, the presence of him should scare back XDG a little bit. It's not actually doing so very early on in laning phase, because Zuna and Sheep are still pushing up fairly aggressively. But even so, the TSM laners are just playing better right now. Stronger champion, slightly better play.
Xmithie towards the bottom lane. Like we were saying, this is his first time on Kha'Zix coming into the spring split, although he did have that position in AD carry previously in the first few weeks. But we'll have to see. He was the most improved jungler coming out of the spring, or I'm sorry, the summer. We'll see if Kha'Zix really puts an impact on this game for him.
Yeah, very slow start. TSM doesn't need to do much, because you can see just from the lanes, they're already picking up a fairly large edge.
500 gold, easily in their favor. Bjergsen can make sure he gets these attacks on while staying safe. You can see Mancloud, not full health. Bjergsen having a great time in a safe spot, just throwing shurikens out all day long. See what Xmithie can do to react. It's really on him in these next few minutes to kind of tilt the game. Sixes are about to come up. We can see the mid laners are halfway to 6 right now, and it's going to be that help from the jungle.
Yeah, trying to find ways for XTG to maybe get a bit of control in this game. They're going to want to do a fairly early dragon or dragon fight with Gragas, where Mancloud would have the ability to separate TSM's team. They also might want Benny to come down a little bit on Shyvana since he's already losing the lane to Renekton. And Kha'Zix wants more fights. That's the biggest thing for him, especially once he gets that ultimate evolution. I believe he would evolve his R now with the new Kha'Zix because of 2 seconds of stealth instead of one. I think that's what XGG would want to do. Up until that point, they just need to survive and make sure they stay at least even on item breakpoints. That's going to be a big thing for them.
This works out really well. We'll see if ManCloud pushes this lane because he just got six, and Bjergsen would have had to back there without getting it. But he himself gets it. I was going to say Dragon was going to become a little easier for XDG there, but everybody will be ready with the ults at that time. 6.5 minutes in, Dyrus looks like he's full rage in that top lane. Benny doesn't want any of that level 6 to level 5.
Yeah, real strong early on. Not too much more to say about TSM's game plan here because it's fairly straightforward.
They're not being pressured in anything else.
They're not being pressured. This is kind of how you would expect a 8-versus-1 matchup to start in North American LCS, with just TSM crushing the laning phase and having control over XDG.
That was a good move by Xsmithy there in the mid. We did see the gank, but previously he was trying to find the odd one. So he's keeping it in his mind that they got to put some aggressive wards down as he did at the Wraith. If he sees the odd one, it's a huge one-up. If not, they get a gank in mid. So we'll see if they keep that in mind as well. They're still down about 400, more than that, 800 gold right now. It's going to be a big thing for them. Oh, no, 1,000 gold, I'm sorry. We're looking at it wrong.
What numbers are we reading? This is a whole bunch, but it looks like a little bit of action in the bot lane, actually.
Mm-hmm. Oh, coming up onto Caitlyn. Very nice try for Zuna. We saw Zuna getting hit up quite hard in his last few games in the preview show. He was going down time after time again, and it was on that Caitlyn. He's been trying to do a lot. 4 plays now, 1-3. He's trying to bring that record up along with the team.
The Dragon fight should hopefully be forced by XTG fairly quickly. One negative thing about TSM not really buying many wards, XTG not buying wards, is they wouldn't necessarily have control over the Dragon Pit. But because they want to go for it, they're putting down a lot of pink wards in the area so that if Odd One does come to try and help, they can just maybe even do it. They might think about doing it straight up now.
This is quite scary. A level 5 Xsmithy. Odd One just hit 6, but he's low on mana.
He is taking way too much damage for this. But if TSM doesn't react because they just chopped in the base, they will be able to just get this dragon uncontested.
Wow. XDG really putting a risk on this one. High risk, high reward indeed. It's going to take him a little bit longer. ManCloud's even going to get back to the lane before he loses too much experience to the turret. We only have 500 gold difference now to that 1,000 that just was.
Yeah, it kind of goes to show how much they were losing the lanes, how they can take an uncontested dragon and still be down.
Yeah.
400 gold. TSM won't want to let that happen again in 6 minutes. That's going to be the fight, I think, that would really break out. There's a chance this turns into a very low-kill game, just with the way the lanes are playing out.
We see actually Bjergsen.
Here
he
comes, though.
It's going to be the ultimate coming out of the flash. Tibbers, one goes down. That's Sheep. He gets harvested. Zuna's going to be the next. The Culling. He throws down the barrier. It's going to be more hate spikes. And the final one takes down Zuna. Good control in the bottom lane at 9 minutes.
Yeah, really nice timing on that gank by TSM, because even though they gave up the dragon, they immediately knew what to do to get back at them. Knowing that the dragon was so early, fight mid.
Ooh, Bjergsen going hard. Ooh, very nice.
Got him.
Oh, the ignite goes down. The turret shot hit. That's why you didn't see more damage come on, because he had already taken the damage and he gets out alive.
Yeah, that was an outplay by Bjergsen. He didn't even have to burn flash for that. But the timing of the dragon by TSM, when a team does a very early dragon like that, they would know that Xsmithy would be very low on health. So just running in for a full-on gank like that, they know they're not going to get 3v3'd, and it's an easy 3v2 move for them, meaning it's a very safe gank in the bottom lane. Mid lane, of course, was just Bjergsen being Bjergsen.
Yep, Bjergsen actually getting the blue buff from Odd One as well. We'll see how he takes this in consideration. Blue buff allows him to throw out Qs, means more damage, means death to ManCloud.
Yeah, it was interesting. He had his W clone out a little bit longer, and right before it was going to die, he teleported back to it, got a hit in, and then started his ultimate. So he really snuck in damage at the opportune times. Surprising ManCloud there.
Doesn't look like the off week did too much to Bjergsen. He was getting what he needed on the US servers. 15-6 to 13,000 gold right now. Only 10 minutes into the game, and TSM is definitely taking a commanding lead. Core items almost being built up. We already see the Lizard Elder built up onto the Odd One. It's going to be more objectives for them and more control.
Yeah, the kill on ManCloud is also very well synchronized with this push in the mid lane. because they know that the blue buff is off of Mancloud, meaning his wave clear potential is a lot lower. And if they want to rotate and try to get multiple turrets down early on, they can.
So many options for TSM to go forward in this game. Right now, they're just using the slow roll so far. They haven't really taken down the too many turrets except for the one in the bottom lane. And Dragon's going to be up in a few minutes, so they're going to go topside for now and see what they can work up.
Benny has ultimate. He has pretty much everything, but no one in this top lane is shopped. They might be very surprised that more people on the map exist here, and we'll see how Benny reacts.
Everybody took a boat over to the island, and they're ready to dock. Here we go. Odwin and Xspecial coming off first. He's going to make him walk the plank. Benny tries to get out of this one on the backside, though, and it looks like he's going to burn Flash as well as the Dragon's Descent. Everybody's going to be heading up here. Bjergsen looks like he's holding middle because he's being pushed in from Xsmithie and Mancloud. Yeah. He has tied his shoes real tight going coast to coast.
Odwin's got
to
be real careful.
Puts on the burnout. Xsmithie comes around, and Benny's going to make it out safely.
Really good escape there by Benny, finding the right angle to escape the three-man gank, even burn the flash of Dyrus. So a lot invested there. XGG has to make something else happen off of Benny's big play.
Oh, Turtle's got to put on the hard shell for this one. He's going real low. Barrier goes on. He's holding him quite well. The net takes him down. Sheev gets himself just out of turret range.
Good reaction there by XGG and a very dangerous move. Wild Turtle did a nice juke of the flay, but still didn't have enough because it was a very brute force two-man turret dive.
Huge wards coming up behind XDG, keeping them pretty safe so they can do dives like that. Sheep already had the Sight Stone coming in, as well as Xspecial in that bottom lane. Right now we're 3-1. We're just 12 minutes in and there weren't too many kills, but they're getting racked up now, and that's what we like to see. Still only one turret though, as it's been killed on the champions, not on the turrets.
Yeah, and now though that Benny's ultimate is down, he's in a bit more danger in the top lane. Odwin's hoping to find a counter jungle opportunity onto Smithy. He would have timed his red buff the second time around. He knows it's coming up soon.
And check this out. We've been seeing a lot of Tiamats, a lot of aggressive starts, and this still counts as aggressive, but Dyrus is going for that Blade of the Rune King with a Cutlass first on his Renekton.
Yeah, it's a very interesting build. I think he's just going for even more lane killing power. Mm-hmm. Benny's letting Dyrus shove in anyway, so he doesn't care about shoving extremely quickly with a Tiamat. And as far as chasing him down, the slow from the Bilgewater Cutlass might come in handy for him. So that's why he's going that build.
Rocking out the Ninja Top, being the top lane for now. He is against quite a bit of AD and didn't want any pressure from Xsmithie coming in. Slice and dice. You can see the damage trade's actually pretty even back and forth. And Bjergsen again, I'm going to be taking that blue buff.
Yeah, I mean, Zed still uses it for energy cost, and he can spam a lot more. Even though energy comes back fairly quickly, cooldown reduction on the ultimate as well is nice. Wild Turtle's got to watch out.
Oh, the Fog of War playing against Wild Turtle on this one. He cannot get out. XCG, very nice play.
I think that's a big misplay by Wild Turtle. He was obviously trying to get vision of the area, but knowing that Odwin had just taken the red buff on the other side, they probably just weren't communicating, because Odwin should have told him that Kha'Zix may have been near, and he shouldn't have been that far up.
Instant Morello Namakon build up here for Mancloud as we see the bottom lane getting pressured. XDG should grab this tower.
Yeah, nice moves in the bottom lane by XDG. Really, a lot of that happened off of Benny's great escape in the top lane.
Yeah.
They're at least staying in the game here.
It's a good point. Interesting how little things across the map can really escalate and just kind of create a ripple effect. Now down towards the bottom, you see that turret go down. It evens up the turrets. Gold is still a bit of a deficit here for XDG as they try to get themselves around. They're still trying to get forward wards in and keep themselves in this one.
The roaming really starts happening now because both AD carries and supports are free to go. Knowing there's a flash up on Annie as well makes everything more dangerous, and this is a big dragon fight. You know how TSM realized right after the dragon had been taken? They want to get everyone down here in the bottom lane. Dyrus making it very obvious that he's up here. This should be an uncontested dragon. Ooh. It's just a matter of how much turret damage Benny gets.
Dyrus is 11. Bjergsen is 11. Mancloud is not, and neither is Benny. So they got alts leveled up on that one as well. So like you said, going to TSM, a smart move for XDG. They got the first dragon. They're equaled in turrets. The laning phase in a few kills is really where you're seeing the discrepancy.
Yeah, look at that CS difference in the top lane. It was more. It's now 33 because Dyrus spent all that time to roam down. And because Benny hadn't even been near the turret of Dyrus, they are able to get the dragon trade for not much negative consequences.
It's going to be something big in the mid lane for TSM if XDG can't come up big themselves. It's already Lucian and Annie going their Wild Turtle Xspecial as we see Benny coming up top here with Xsmithy looking to get some kills onto Dyrus. He got those Ninjatabi, so not going to take too much damage, but Xsmithy can still get a good chunk on him.
Yeah, Dyrus has to be a little bit cautious not to completely all-in Benny here, but outside of that, he is in a pretty safe zone.
It's kind of one of the good things about Renekton. No, Zunok, very close, flashes to keep the distance. One more shot, he's not even going to need it. Look at that, he just walks away from the explosion.
It's a very unsafe zone there. Bjergsen showing why he is the best Zed player in North America. Wait a little bit so he can E all the creeps at once. Blade of the Ruined King plus Brutalizer is the point in the game where he kills the AD carry, and he found him.
This is what makes it hard to play against an Eve. The regular wards aren't really going to make you privy to Eve's presence. It looks like they're not really going to be able to get too much damage down. Dyrus just going for the tickle fight.
I really wonder. Odd One's probably waiting in the wings, hoping to find some gank support. They don't want to dive the Shyvana, but they're trying to catch people helping out Shyvana.
Sheep giving a little bit of help to Mancloud here in mid. Getting some souls for himself. Mancloud at 148, as we were saying. Picking up a bit of CS here to Bjergsen at 159.
Ooh, jungle fight.
Pink Ward, ooh, yeah, he did not want any of that. So Xsmithy keeps that top side of the jungle a bit safer for the team as they might be rotating top side. It looks like they're gonna want Benny sometime soon.
Let's actually pay attention to how long that Pink Ward lasts for XDG.
Yeah.
It'll be a good indicator of how much control or fear exists in this game.
They put high priority on their bus. They got one on each.
Yeah, if Odd One's able to go in and get those, it'll mean XDG has completely lost control.
Something Mancloud definitely needs, Xsmithy as well, to be sure and keep the mentality of the team up, knowing that they can walk into their own jungle, they can set up their own ganks, because once those paths are closed off, TSM is going to know exactly where and when they're coming into a fight. 4-2, 17-30 into the game as Wild Turtle again gets himself into a sticky situation, but enough out of that one that he gets himself to safety.
Yeah, still has Flash and Barrier up. This is a split push by TSM. They're trying a bit of a, it would be a 3-on-1, but they have even too many people off on the side for it. So that means XDG is trying to counter by pushing up mid lane. They can't stay there very long because the split push of TSM will eventually overcome and take the side lanes.
Looks like they know Benny's going to have to back. Special is kind of closing off and cutting the pie there so nobody else can make it through the jungle. They're going to probably kill Benny in that top lane as Mancloud comes to hover on the bottom. Benny gets away safely. Wild Turtle's now the focus, but Odd One throwing down the ultimate, and he keeps going. Agony's Embrace into the hate spike. Zuna's going to throw down the 90 caliber net. No red buff for Odd One means a safe Zuna.
That was such a nice W by the Odd One as well. He ate the slow from the box and then W'd to cleanse the slow. It didn't end up burning anything extra. It was just really nice skill usage. They caught a couple XGG members still playing in the anti-split push way when everyone had peeled back.
Bjergsen getting a little ahead of himself on this one. Antsy Pansy, there goes Xsmithy with the ultimate down. He's going to hit Bjergsen with a quick Q. One more auto attack coming in. The assist goes to Mancloud.
But meanwhile, in the mid lane, they did kill Zuna, and all that collapse down in the bottom lane is granting TSM a turret.
Going to be able to take out the wave as well that's coming in, so they have a little bit of breathing room, but they got to watch Benny from the top side. Very low mana. Odd One gets hooked from the max range. Sheep on the flash play, actually stopping the flash from Odd One and then hitting it up with the hook. Good kill coming in for Benny.
TSM a little bit sloppy in this game. Honestly, they have won the lanes by a lot, but they are getting caught in a few rotations by XDG. This is mostly reactionary play, but this was the nice kill, flashing in for Zuna and just deleting him off the
You're
map.
You're supposed to be safe in between your turrets.
Well,
sometimes. Sometimes.
TSM has a habit of killing Zuna over and over again. It happened over during Super Week as well. They really picked on him. He was 1-6 or 1-7 by the end of that last game.
Sometimes when you can get under that person's skin, and even not even under their skin, make sure they're just not the same level or same experience, it can really hurt them. But to Zuna's court, he is doing a great job. 11-11 as Wild Turtle actually just hit that. 161-160. So even though they have his number, he's sticking in this one.
I mean, maybe some of the Zuna picking on comes from all the way back at the start of the Season 3 Spring Split. Zuna used to be the guy who would try to vocally intimidate the enemy team by yelling really loudly after all the kills. Because
vocal
back in
warfare.
The old studio, players were at fairly close. You could hear the shouts through the microphones because they were fairly close to each other there. And it was actually when Chaox was on TSM, he would try and counter with yells of his own. TSM has the last laugh, though. They tend to win these games.
Indeed, especially three turrets, or two turrets up, but three turrets down right now. They're definitely turning out the lights on the side of XDG. Each one of those turrets that goes down creates a little bit more fog that you are not sure about walking into. 25 seconds on the dragon. Should see Xsmithie start to hover down towards the bottom side of the map, but you see TSM is already in place to set up that defensive wall. They're already a few steps ahead to be at Dragon.
This next fight could break the game wide open, or just catching XGG. Everything XGG is doing is reacting to what TSM has planned.
Oh, Bjergsen says, yes, hook me in. This is what you want. But he got taken to the other side as well. The death mark takes him down. Odd one throwing down the W, keeps himself safe, and XDG is left to scramble.
Gyrus is inside four people right there.
Yeah, he is trying to do what he can. Throws down the call. The Meek, that had a full rage onto it, half rage rather. But it looks like they will get a good engage. I don't know about the follow-up, though, to keep it going.
It's all good because there's the dragon coming up. Like I said, XDG is just getting pushed around by TSM. Yes, they've been able to pick up a couple kills off of TSM's aggression, but it's just not enough. This gold lead is just going to continue to grow. All the pink wards that XDG had set up in their own jungle have been killed, and this is maybe a suicidal defense.
TSM is one of those teams that knows when they can pressure a lead. Great smite by Odd One gets that down. The dragon is TSM's, and it looks like they get the kill as well onto Xsmithie. They are just throwing themselves into these fights. They know they have the power to.
Yeah, Xsmithie tried a desperation steal there. It's almost like XGG is just hoping that someone is going to make a play. Xsmithie tried at that point, but it wasn't like the whole team was on the page. He was the only one who went in. Everyone else had to just run away.
Mancloud building up the Morello Namakon first, trying to do what he can against Bjergsen in mid. Does not have the Rabadons, doesn't have the Void Staff, isn't in a position to carry the game for his team. XGG is really going to have to hold out here for the long haul if they want to make an impact and getting back. Maybe TSM messes up with the Baron, but right now, like I said, they have the chance to mess up. They'll still be in the lead.
Bjergsen wanted to kill somebody over the wall. Is he going to stop his back? Yeah? He just wants the minions. He's greedy. He's pretty close to his last whisper. He can easily go back and buy
it. 2,400 right there.
He might be trying to get a Black Cleaver and a Last Whisper, but I don't think he has quite enough for that.
Oh, he's pretty much the main damage source. We saw Dyrus did have the Cutlass, but right after that, he goes for the Banshee's Veil, like straight out.
Oh,
that Warden's Nail, Warden's Nail didn't
come
in. Yeah, wow, yeah. So he goes for right for the Black Cleaver and Last Whisper. Money bags.
Yeah. Whoever he goes for is going to die. Unless XGG
as usual
gets a lot of armor and health very soon. Yeah, TSM has a monstrous lead here. It's just grown and grown because XGG's been getting pushed around so much.
Very strong play from all the lanes. We didn't get any roaming from Mancloud or even Bjergsen, but I think that was Bjergsen's control of the mid lane. He knew he didn't need to go anywhere. Wild Turtle Special had bottom with the Odd One, and Dyrus was just doing his thing in top lane. You can see that already, or that right now, I should say, 254 to 183 in that lane, and it's second tier turret.
It's across the board. Literally everyone on TSM has more CS than their counterparts, even the supports and the junglers at this point. And these pink wards are futile, it seems, for XDG. If someone would walk into that brush, they would see it and be able to get rid of it. Any minute now, they're going to check that brush.
Strong pink ward stays alive.
Yeah.
See where they go from here.
Get it!
Cheers for the strong pink ward. Wild Turtle in mid lane, farming up some sieges. He looks like he's in a safe spot right now. Zuna has not left the safety of his team anymore. He knows he is being targeted out here. TSM has some satellite overhead scanning whatever position he's in. They find a way to get to him.
Yeah, and this is just the 3-1-1 split. Push by TSM. Three people in the mid lane. They never really know where Odd One is, so both the solo lanes can't feel safe for XGG. And this time, TSM's just sat in the head up top and gets some turret pressure. But here comes the spike.
That was a very nice barrel, but yeah, the death mark's going to go down. You know when it's marked, you can see those shurikens above his head. Little treat trick.
Yeah, unfortunately the barrel took Zed with him when he was trying to body slam away. At least he has his Zhonya's Hourglass now, so he will be somewhat immune to that burst of damage.
He's still got a good bit of damage out, but that means a good bit has to happen more than once, so Mancloud cannot go down immediately in these fights. Whoa, Xsmithie takes a double Q.
He might still be able to get him.
That ultimate is halfway up for Bjergsen. He doesn't really have any shadows to play with right now, only that escape. He could go back right now, but I don't think he's going to be able to. A quick Q from Xsmithie, and it looks like that could be Baron going down. They pull into it. It's going to be the smite going down from the Odd One. That's two dead XDG members as Benny tries to figure his way out of the Baron pit. Dyrus coming up from the other side. Looks like they're going to sandwich in the dragon.
XDG just doesn't have enough resources to respond to what TSM is doing right now. They needed the jungler down bottom to kill Bjergsen, but that means they have no smite for the Baron buff and not enough damage to push them off. Ooh. He gets cold.
Zuna trying to do what he can, but he doesn't want to get too close to that party. Looks like they're going to be able to do a little bit of damage. do this turret, but not fully take it down just yet.
Yeah, back and forth, 11-6.
Okay,
TSM
taking
still
it down.
Taking this down. Darius is just a monster at this point in the game.
Yeah, Zuna. I figured Zuna would have done a bit more, but I didn't see his inventory. Only the Zeal right now after that Bloodthirster. So he has just been stranglehold in the bottom lane. And red buff being taken away. Zuna Doom trying to steal it, but he cannot even get close. Just the one-offs TSM is getting right now is creating such a lead for them. 10,000 to be a matter of fact in gold. 5-2 in turrets, 26 minutes into this one. They've won since the lanes, and they're methodically doing it after that. TSM, as I said before, is one of those teams that knows when they have a lead, and they're able to pressure.
And this is a really nice execution of just a good split push by TSM. Mm-hmm. They've been able to get this huge lead, completely avoiding team fighting, where Benny and ManCloud would actually be fairly strong, and X-Smithy would be able to hop around and get some resets. That is a pretty scary Zed in the top lane. It's just he swapped lanes a little bit since there's his Anya's on ManCloud's side. And also the team could probably go take that exposed turret down to the bottom. The I'd like to call it the middle turret in the bottom lane. Does that make sense? Inner turret. That's a better word.
Well, we'll see what they have. Bjergsen's very strong, and XDG really has nobody that can take that damage. We just talked a little bit about ManCloud, but that's about it. And Bjergsen's, he can go for Benny. He probably won't in the fights, but we already saw he can take Benny to half health as well. So how can XDG fight these if they even engage?
Yeah, they would need to be able to kill a split pusher in a 1v1 at this point, but they just don't have the capability of doing that right now. That means while they're trying to rotate these turrets, they're getting picked off.
Control of the jungle is definitely Team Solo Mids. They own both halves of the map right now, even with the amount of pink wards in that topside jungle for XDG. Two turrets going down, or one turret going down as the top one is also being pressured. TSM looks to drop the inhibitor.
The pink wards aren't bad by XDG. They just don't have enough gold to fight these guys off because they've given up too many advantages. TSM brute forcing through.
Dyrus tanking that one pretty much from the start there, and it looks like they're going to keep going. Smithy doing what he can to the back line. He gets out, gets the stun from Xspecial, but it's not going to be enough. There's the coordination from XDG, but not the damage right now.
Nice inhibitor take. They might just rotate around. Maybe shot first. Bjergsen going in for Xspecial. Oh, nice
he got
shot.
The Q. That'll do it. The shield not going to do enough. Bjergsen coming in, calculated.
Having fun on Zed, building more damage on top of what he already has.
Always great to watch him on that side.
Very mean play by him.
We saw the shadows. It's cool for us. BM to the other team. 13-6 as Dragon goes down once again. Favorite Team Solo mid as Dyrus hanging out in mid lane. He is quite a big boy right now. Looking to build in a Sunfire cape next. Actually, stayed on the Cutlass just for kind of that laning thing.
TSM has about 10,000 unspent gold in their inventory right now, but they have so much map pressure up that they're thinking about just continuing this push.
Yeah.
It's been so easy for them, and they have Xsmithy down. They're trying to get this before going back. It's slightly dangerous, but they should be safe.
They cannot even go off grabbing Xspecial right to the back line. Zuna goes down. He was what was on the menu for dinner. Benny's going to be there as well. Going straight past the turrets. The cast goes all the way through everyone.
Wrong
Doesn't
way.
Really do too much damage. Turtle does go down on that one. That's a shutdown for ManCloud. TSM's going to be forced to scatter on this one, but they'll be back.
Yeah, 15,000 gold up. I feel like Bjergsen wants to try and get a kill.
He has got that stun up.
Better minds do prevail. Did he get the pink ward? He sees it. He walked right past it. I don't think he saw it. They're like, hey, guys, they saw you. Oh,
Smithy. Very nice.
It was really smart. He didn't jump all the way over the wall. He just jumped in range so he could smite it. Let's check out this last fight.
So Xspecial getting grabbed, and then it was Zuna.
It was Zuna, yeah. They got the stun on him for the split second and allowed Wild Turtle to burst him down with damage. And then a very nice angled culling there by Wild Turtle to get enough damage down on the Sheep. But of course, when you dive that deeply into the base with all that unspent gold, people can come from their fountain with full health and mana. And that's one of the big reasons ManCloud could take him down.
So I thought the cast missed, but it did push Wild Turtle on that one. I was looking at the top of the fight. So ManCloud gets a good bit of damage on that one. They could have hoped for better. The base starting to become shambles right now as that bottom lane is taken out. Baron's up in 2 minutes. I don't know if TSM is going to need to go back for it, but they won't have any problems if they do.
Yeah, and check out Bjergsen's build as well. He finished a Ravenous Hydra to combo. A lot of Zeds like to stack activatable items that deal extra damage during their death mark. Because all that damage is stored up. So he's going to be jumping on, spamming all his abilities, also Blade of the Rune King, plus the Ravenous Hydra active, all within that window so that the Death Mark hits even harder. If he wanted to go even more aggressive, he would build a Sword of the Divine as his last item, so all of his auto attacks crit. He's already a little bit excessive in damage, though.
We're saying it could happen, though.
It could happen.
All right.
GA would be the smarter choice.
We'll see. It's all damage right now for these guys, and Vision for more damage. He's got the Boots of Lucidity, so he can keep spitting out spells as well on those cooldowns. McSmithy's been soaking up that blue buff for his team because he's really the only one that can get out in the jungle to grab it. We saw him getting that smite last time as Mancloud was there to help, but to no avail. Zuna taking damage just from over the wall. Oh my gosh, they haven't even started the fight yet, and these guys are already down to half health on some. Wild Turtle eats that. It only takes a quarter.
Yeah, a little bit of Zed poke over the wall is getting a lot of this down. Hook on a Dyrus, maybe XGG would want to go because of how low Dyrus is at the very least.
Oh dear.
It makes it a little bit more scary. They got to deal with those super minions though as well. This is just too much for XGG to deal with. Already down 15k gold.
They got the minion split push going down in the bottom lane as that turret gets quite hit. Doesn't even get to use the death mark. It was an explosion. Cuts the arteries of Zuna. He goes down quick, bleeds out. It's going to be the inhibitor as well. 20 seconds on the Baron, but I don't even think TSM needs to look that far back on the map. That'll just be other court side. There's the box going down. They try to throw down the Agony's Embrace for the rest of the damage. Cullen coming out, but there's a fight on both sides of the base right now. It's going to be Xmithie going down as Mancloud does what he can with the last two turrets and Benny being up.
TSM only 32 minutes into the game. Nice performance. No questions about Bjergsen's ability to come back to the team. That was just 1v8 matchup. TSM extends their record to 18-3.
Great communication, very strong play, and it does look like the band is back together as Team Solo Mid picks up another victory.
Bjergsen, a very strong performance on Zed. Never really team fighting because he didn't have to. 8 kills, 2 deaths, only 1 assist. But that's because he was just soloing people.
Dyrus finally getting a Guardian Angel in the end of that game. 2 Banshee's Veils going across them. They made sure that they couldn't be, you know, popped or poked out or see any bit of the front end damage that a barrel could have brought or a Kha'Zix Q could have brought. So they were, even though they were so far ahead, they were saying we're taking no chances still on the explosive power of your team.
The struggles for XDG continue as well.
Yeah.
You don't really expect them to bounce back against the number one team in North America. They had a couple nice plays there responding to TSM's over-aggression, but they were never really able to make their own moves.
Strong play, like we said, Bjergsen coming in on Zed. That'll be his third game there, 3-0 for him. Dyrus playing a strong Renekton in the top lane. Renekton, like you said, was banned 3 times against Team Solo Mid. That's not a lot, which means Dyrus is still winning these games as well, just not on Renekton, on other champions. We've seen him on Shyvana going crazy, super tank mode, raid boss style.
But yeah.
These games are just keep flowing in the way of Team Solo Mid.
That's one of the biggest things about TSM in this new 2014 season. I don't think they've ever been better as a team. They had a lot of dominance way back in Season 2, at least on the North American stage. But that may have just been because it wasn't as competitive of a scene. They were so good individually that they just kind of carried through. But now, you know, Bjergsen, I think, being mechanically the best mid laner in North America, Dyrus has been so steady. The fact that everyone in their own right is playing their own game, but then they can still come together as a team is making them so lethal right here. They legitimately do have a chance to go 25-3, which after Cloud9 did in the summer split, we're thinking, you know, no one's going to do that again.
Right.
It's too competitive.
A lot of it comes out of picks and bans. Teams will say picks and bans were a huge thing. I think Dominate pointed out as one of the big things at IEM, that picks and bans were huge for these teams. And uniquely picked, Mancloud has 11 champions in mid lane. Gragas was one he'd already picked, so it stays at 11.
0-5 now for him on Gragas.
Bjergsen has 7 picks. A lot of the picks on TSM are a lot less unique of 5, a unique of 7.
Yeah.
So they can always go back to those main ones. Other teams are trying to go outside their own box and say, well, maybe we can try this game. And it seems to be hurting.
And, I mean, it's probably too early to start, like, looking way forward into this, but knowing that the top team from North America will be representing the region at the All-Star game, you have to ping TSM and Cloud9 as being highly competitive for that part. We saw at IM Katowice how well Cloud9 did, but there were a lot of TSM fans who were saying, what if TSM was there? How well would have they done? Because at least internationally, they're built to succeed much more than they ever have been. And I really can't wait for that stuff to happen.
It's going to be interesting. TSM has really never done good as they go overseas, but
I think it's pretty safe to say they've pretty much never done
never.
Well.
Okay, we'll say
at least against Asian teams, like in some of the very early European like Gamescom back in the day. They did do well against those European teams. But, yeah, against any type of Korean team, they have generally just lost.
And that's got to get on your mentality, too. Coming into these games, especially what Dyrus was hearing last year when some of the top Korean laners were saying that, you know, Dyrus actually surprised me, this and that. But to hear that, it's kind of like you get to the end of the game and they're like, hey, you know, you did awesome in lane. GG, you lost. You know?
It's like, you did great, man. Good job. I do think, though, that TSM is stronger than they've ever been, as I was saying before. And it's just because of, you know, they did bring some international flavor in. They've tried and failed a couple of times, and they've stayed at it. They're the most veteran team in NA as well.
It's something this year as well, a lot more teamwork and camaraderie as to drama and single personalities, if you will. So it's definitely helping them
getting out. Getting along real well.
Indeed. Let's throw it across the studio where Freak and Kobe are joined by a member of the victorious Team Solo Mid.
Thank you very much, Rivi. I want to welcome Bjergsen back to North America and to the analyst desk. Pretty terrific return right there, 8-2-1 on Zed. Good job. Basically, what were you thinking coming into that game?
I was kind of worried because Reginald did like really well in my place, and I just really wanted to perform and just do at least as well as Reggie, because I felt like a lot of people were like really happy to see him back, but I wanted like people to be happy that I'm back too.
Jealous of Reggie a little bit? Wow.
A little bit. But he did really well.
All right, so this game, though, even though XCG did get the first dragon without any attempt from you guys to do anything about it, you guys had such a tremendous lead in CS in the lanes. Really, how did this unfold for you and Dyrus, really?
We just got, like, really strong laners. Like, our solo lanes are both, like, really strong champions for the laning phase, and they're kind of supposed to get, like, a slight lead somehow. And also, like, just giving up the dragon gives you, like, better buy timers, you get to push out, you have like a lot of pressure on the map, and the first dragon doesn't give that much gold when it's that early in the game, so we just decided to leave it up and just trade it for stronger lanes and more pressure.
And it seemed to really work out for you guys, actually. I want to grab a replay of the early kill you got against Mancloud in the mid lane there, the Zed vs. Gragazat play, if we can get that on your screen, because basically walk me through how you know you can take him out.
It's pretty much like I throw my shadow forward and I've been harassing him a lot. I see he starts drinking, so I think I can go back in. And at that point, like, I just know that he's low enough for me to pull out the combo. And here I'll say, okay, I think he's dead. I think he's dead. And he was.
And you survived.
I did.
Good. The explosive cast in the turret. Did you calculate that you could take that kind of burst back? Like, did you know Gragas could knock you into the turret when you all end?
That was actually, like, almost, like, worst case scenario, because I didn't manage to dodge either his Q or his ult with my ult. Mm-hmm. I was, like, slightly too late on my ult. If I played it better, I would have been, like, way healthier. So.
Sure.
Now, having just, you know, revisited the Europe scene and played solo queue a little bit over there, you have a fresh comparison now, again, of European solo queue mid laners versus North American.
Yeah.
What would you say is your second take on the Switch?
I actually think, like, EU in solo queue, I think the mids are better because there are more. It's like mid lane mains in solo queue. Every single game I play solo queue in EU, I always face a mid lane main, which is refreshing because there aren't as many in NA. I feel like there might be more jungle mains here. So that's just like one major thing that I really notice is that every time I play against someone, he's always maining mid. I guess it makes it like slightly harder or better practice for solo queue.
And it seems like you're in great form after all the practice, so good job on that one. We have another replay we want to get your attention on, actually. It's the end game team fight in the enemy base. We can get that on your screen. Walk me through the basically crushing blow here.
Yeah, pretty much like Dyrus tank tower so we can get some damage. And I see Zuna's low, so I'm just saying like, I'm just going to kill Zuna. And I just go in here. I instantly pop Zuna. Like, my death mark didn't even need to go off. And here, it's like, we just decide to take turrets and the inhib, because there's no reason to chase too far into the Nexus turrets or base. So we just kind of play it safe and just get all the tires that we need. I think soon they actually, like, re-engage with the Gragas. Because at this point, they have to do something, or with Audun as well. They kind of have to do something. Otherwise, they're just going to lose. And they try, but we're just so far ahead that we're just going to, like, we're bound to win that fight.
Yeah, and I was actually impressed with you guys. You took a very, what's the word I'm looking for? Like a very cautious approach to the game. You took your time with that one, kind of methodical, and just sort of waited with the split push. Why, when you're that far ahead, why not just, like, oh, just push mid and win at 20 minutes?
They have, like, a lot of wave clear in their comp. They have Caitlyn, they have Gragas, so it's hard to just go all mid. And our comp is, like, with Zed, you want to be looking to split push. You don't want to just, like, let's go mid and push. So we felt like just we felt like our comp was going to be better later, so we just kind of took it slow and took it safe. Also because we kind of threw a lot of scrims like
really?
Last couple of days. So
okay.
Yeah, we just played it like as safe as possible.
All right, so looking forward, you know, you guys last 7 games. A lot of people are saying it's really how you end the split, not even how you started it. So what are you guys going to – what's the team mentality like looking towards the playoffs and looking towards All-Stars?
Yeah, for me, I think the season is really important too because it sets the tone. If you're a top team, you want to stay a top team. And I don't know, I just feel like it's not like – it doesn't matter, the split, but we're just really preparing hard for playoffs. Like, we're just doing everything we can to, like, only focus on league and focus on strategies and getting as much help from Reggie as possible to improve our game. And obviously, we, like, really want to go to All-Stars. It's our main goal. Mm-hmm.
And, of course, at this point, you're going to play each team about one more time through the last 7 games. Dignitas is your matchup yesterday. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about that one? Tomorrow, yeah.
Yeah, it's fine. I haven't been watching, like, too many of the other teams while I was gone because I was just mainly focusing on, like, solo queue. I mainly watched, like, our matches and C9's matches. Mm-hmm. But I think Dig are, like, a team that can either do, like, super well or, like, kind of crumble. So I feel like it really depends on what day we hit Dignitas. And it can be a really difficult matchup for sure.
Yeah, so then coming into this one, actually, you've kind of, since you've taken all that time back, this is your first sort of competitive actual pro matches on 4.3. Is there anything in the patch that's interested you with the Cassidy nerfs? Like, it still got banned against you. Anything that sticks out?
I don't remember too much from the patch, but I think Cassidy is still a good pick. I wouldn't say that he's always first pick, like, every single situation, because mm-hmm. I feel like if you have a comp built around, like, playing against him and a lane matchup, then he's, like, not that great. But if you use him as a counter pick, he's still, like, an extremely strong pick, and he should be a champion that every team should have up their sleeve if a team picks, for example, like a Nidalee, like some weak laner that Cassidy mm-hmm. could do well against.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll see if we see that throughout the week. Bjergsen, thank you very much for your time. Congrats on your win. 7 more to go. See if you can tie the record for regular season wins and losses. Guys, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, the Gintas will fight to hold on to 4th place when they face off against Curse. We'll be right back.
One of the good things about connecting. No, Zunok, very close. Flashes to keep the distance. One more shot. He's not even going to need it.
Oh, he's alone. He's alone.
He's
alone. He has ult, though. He has Zonias as well.
You got him. You got him.
I'm pushing top hard. I'm pushing top hard.
Arthur, you got him. Okay.
Nice. Just redive now.